Senate President Juan Miguel Zubiri wants to expedite the procurement of defense equipment in the face of China's incursions in Philippine waters. Now, he's saying the process can be both stringent and quick to help the Philippines better respond to China's aggression. He's also pushing for the passage of the Philippine Defense Industry Development Bill, which seeks to promote local production of defense equipment. As for the budget, Senator Sonny Anggada assures the public lawmakers will prioritize funding for agencies dealing with China's aggressive behavior.
There's increasing tensions in certain parts of the country. So definitely you need to pay attention to these issues. No? So I think that deserves increased funding, definitely.
No. Okay.
Whatever the threats are, then you should respond accordingly. With the budget.
You have Senator Chis Escudero suggesting set aside 100 million, build a structure in Ayungin.
Well, I think it's a great idea, but execution is the problem because just the bringing of supplies already creates some kind of conflict. But we should maybe use exhaust all means, you know, diplomatic and otherwise, so that we can exert our sovereign rights over these areas.
The U.S., Japan, and Australia eyeing joint Navy drills in the South China Sea this week. Citing unnamed security officials, a report by the Associated Press said the drills will include 3 aircraft and helicopter carriers in a show of force. The Philippines, though, will not be part of the exercises due to military logistical limitations. The drill comes as the Philippines hosts ASEAN leaders in China this week for talks on a code of conduct on the South China Sea. The bloc has been negotiating with China on a binding COC that would settle maritime disputes. A draft of a framework agreement was set to be completed by 2021, but the COVID-19 pandemic delayed the discussions. The chairman of the Senate Finance Committee says a sensitive approach is needed in revamping the military and uniformed personnel pension fund. Senator Sonny Anggada admits it will be difficult for those already in service to make sudden individual contributions. He adds lawmakers need to further scrutinize proposals for the MUP pension reform.
Clearly, it's already very difficult to sustain because now the pensions are even bigger than the salaries. Nagbabalun siya. There are no contributions to source the pensions from. That's the difficulty here. So at some point, you really have to make it contributory. So yung madali nga dyan, as I said earlier, is you will ask the new entrants to contribute. But at what point do you ask those in the service already because they've given their blood, they've shed, some have given their lives actually, no? So it's very sensitive and we have to be very sensitive to, yung pagkukonsulta is very important here. And the military, I think, has told us that they don't want to feel like they're being singled out. So it should be a holistic reform of the pension system.
Manila's finance chief earlier allayed concerns over the mandatory contributions. Secretary Benjamin Diokno said government is proposing a loan restructuring for MUPs to help them with the required contribution. Diokno had warned the country may face a fiscal collapse if government fails to overhaul its MUP pension system. As the Philippines' poll body issues guidelines for the administrative transfer of 10 barangays from Makati to Taguig City for the upcoming village and youth polls, the COMELEC approved the recommendation of its law department to consider the villages involved in the territorial dispute to be part of Taguig for the purposes of the upcoming election. See, last week, COMELEC Chairman George Garcia said the transfer of Makati's voter database to Taguig in the affected areas would not be an issue. Earlier, Makati officials insisted Taguig City has to secure a writ of execution before it can formally take over the affected barangays. A sea of yellow at the Santo Domingo Church in Quezon City. This as family and supporters of the late senator and democracy icon Ninoy Aquino gathered to commemorate his 40th death anniversary today. Among those who attended the mass, former Vice President Lenny Robredo and former Senate President Franklin Drilon. Meanwhile, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. expressed solidarity with Filipinos commemorating Ninoy Aquino Day. He urged the public to set aside political differences and unite for the country's welfare and progress. Marcos' statement drew flak from progressive group Bayan. The group said the president's call for unity must be grounded on an honest assessment of history. It adds Aquino's death became a symbol of the brutality under the dictatorship of the president's father. Aquino, who was a staunch critic of the late dictator Ferdinand Marcos Sr., was assassinated upon arriving in Manila from the U.S. 40 years ago. His death sparked public outrage, which led to the EDSA revolution, ending the two-decade rule of Marcos Sr. Well, bad news for motorists as oil prices shoot up for a seventh straight week. Gasoline prices will see the biggest jump at a peso and 10 centavos per liter. Kerosene prices, meanwhile, will go up by 70 centavos per liter. Diesel prices will also see a 20 centavo hike per liter. Fuel prices have been on the rise since July 17. Industry players cited Saudi Arabia's oil production cut as the main reason for the increase in pump prices. Well, make it a double whammy for motorists passing through the Manila-Cavite Expressway. See, aside from high fuel prices, they will now have to deal with the Cavitex toll hike. Our very own Jackie Manaba now joins us with details. Jackie, what more can you tell us?
Carmina, Cavitex started collecting higher toll today, August 21. That's on a holiday Monday. The Manila-Cavite Toll Expressway, or Cavitex, is not expecting much motorists today. However, today, August 21, is the first day that they will be collecting higher toll as approved by the Toll Regulatory Board, or TRB. Cavitex traverses the coast of Manila, connecting Ross Boulevard to Cavite, with two toll plazas in Parañaque Toll Plaza and Kawi Toll Plaza. For Class 1 vehicles traveling from Laia exit to Longos, Bacoor, and vice versa will have to pay 35 pesos toll from previous 33 at the Parañaque Toll Plaza. Class 2 vehicles will be charged 70 pesos instead of 67, and Class 3 will be paying 104 pesos from 100. Meanwhile, motorists traveling from Longos, Bacoor, and Kawit will be charged at the Kawit Toll Plaza. Class 1 vehicles will have to pay 73 pesos from 64. Class 2 will be charged 146 from previous 129. And Class 3 will be paying 219 from 194. The TRB said that they did not expect that these changes will be imposed amid a series of oil price hikes. TRB said these were approved months before and based on the concession agreement between the Metro Pacific Tollways Corporation and the government, which allows for periodic adjustments every 3 years.
A motorcycle riders group slamming government's move to prohibit motorcycle riders from using bike lanes along EDSA. Motorcyclists caught using the bike lane will now be fined 1,000 pesos. The Metro Manila Development Authority, however, says they will let violators off with just a warning today. The motorcycle rights organization is accusing the MMDA of singling them out.
The bike lane was created dahil sa pandemya, no? Kasi nawala ho ang public transport. Ngayon, bumabalik na tayo ulit sa panibagong yugto ng normal na pamumuhay. Ang volume ho ng sasakyan sa kalsada ay nagbabalik na. And wala na ho tayong mga lockdown, so lahat na ho ng tao nakakalabas na. So ang nakikita ko hong problema dito is kailangan pa ba natin ang bicycle lane at this point, or kailangan na ba natin i-adjust ang ating bicycle lane to accommodate other vehicles as well? Selective apprehension lang ang pauiirali nila dito. The road is meant to be shared. We are all paying road tax.
Well, the MMDA denies the allegation.
Yan pong bike lane ay ginawa exclusively for bicycles at yan po ay programa at polisiya ng DOTR. Kami po recently maraming narekong reklamo mula sa bicycle groups na nagsasabi nga po na ino-occupy na ng mga motorsiklo ang bicycle lane at sila po ay nagre-reklamo na parang hindi po namin ginagawa yung aming trabaho. Inobserve naman po namin na totoo po sa basis sa CCTV footages na talagang doon na po sila dumadaan. Pero hindi naman po ibig sabihin noon na amin silang pinag-iinitan dahil po about a month ago, ipinag-utos ko na po na aralin yung pag-share po ng bicycle lane with motorcycles. In fact, nasimulan na po yan sa San Juan.